Welcome to episode 85 of the Spare Change Challenge. I am here partially. I think I'm here physically but not mentally today. It's been a long day. I've been up since early. We've got this raging cold still going on up here. But we're going to play some poker today. And I don't think we'll be doing any high level stuff today. I was just thinking, what's the lowest? What do I need the least brain power to play? And I was thinking, okay, let's just play these $5 hyper turbos. Don't really want to play cash when I don't feel good, and I don't really want to play heads up sit and goes when I don't feel good, because I just think I need more deep brain power to do that. So I think I'll just play some of these brainless hypers, so at least I'm playing something. I'm still a favorite in the game. I'm still likely to make money. So I think it's the lowest variance. It's a high variance game, but I think it's the lowest variance game to play when you're not firing on all cylinders. So I'm just going to stick with that. Play some of these, maybe have a little bit of fun doing it, and we'll go from there. I've played a few of these over the last few days just because I didn't feel like playing anything else. I was supposed to take Sunday and Monday off, but you know, just for fun, I played some of these in the afternoon downstairs on the laptop and had some fun doing it, so there's nothing wrong with that, right? We can play poker and have fun sometimes. But certainly once I'm well, completely well, I'll get back to our normal schedule of what we're playing. But for now, let's just do this and be happy. So I'm going to register and keep four of these up at all times. We'll play these, I don't know if we'll play them a full 2 hours, but certainly try to get, I don't know, 10 or 15 of these things in and see what happens. We're starting just under 1600 today. Let's see if I can get these reordered so I can see what I'm doing here. So we've got three registered so far. Looks like they're filling fairly quickly as well. So that's good. Looks like we'll be able to keep two, three, four of these going at all times, depending on how well I do, of course. If it's one bust after another, it might be challenging, but hopefully that's not the case today. But you never know with these things. So I may have to mute my volume, mute my mic, turn off my webcam occasionally to honk my nose. So I apologize if I do a lot of throat clearing or just not much talk in general because of the way I feel. Because throat's not really sore, it's just very raw, I guess is the way I would put it. So yeah, I probably shouldn't be playing at all today, but I just feel like doing it. Even though I don't feel well, I feel like I'm supposed to start playing today. So maybe we'll just ease into the week by playing some of these. Maybe I'll feel better tomorrow or the next day. Yeah, these colds or sicknesses or viruses that are going around are nasty this year. They're not necessarily that potent. I don't feel terrible. Today is probably a peaking day. Now, I got sick the day before my birthday back on the 25th, and I think that's the nature of whatever this thing is going around, because all of my daughters had it, my wife's had it, and it seems like you're fine for a while, then you go about a week, and you think you're getting better, then boom, all of a sudden you got a temperature, and then you have a temperature for 3 or 4 days. Now, I just have a slight temperature today. But, and then it just kind of have a temperature a few days, then you have a few days where you're just a little bit congested, and then it's over. So I'm thinking this thing is like a 2 to 3 week, I don't know, sentence whenever you get it this year. It's kind of rough. Not fun, that's for sure. I do have the right thing up. I thought I had hold'em indicator up for there for a second. So let's see here. Let's get our fourth one registered. That way we don't have to do that anymore. I like this feature they have on Ignition where once you bust out on one, you just click yes and it auto-registers you for another one. On a site lacking features, that's a pretty cool one. So at least at this level, I feel like the competition is just terrible. So I think you can maintain a decent ROI in these. And by decent, I mean, I don't know, 30-40% maybe. I don't know what a good ROI is in these. Maybe somebody can tell me. I have no clue. I really have no clue. So we do double up in this one, that's good. See, it's plays like that, people calling 10-king out of the blinds, you know, it's just horrible. Horrible, horrible plays, and then stacking off with top pair, which is fine. I guess you have to stack off with top pair, right? Once you hit it in hyper turbo, but just being in the hand in general is just bad. So these games are mostly about stack maintenance and just correct push-fold, reading people's ranges correctly, and not much else to talk about other than that. Just try not to spew too much before you need to spew. When the blinds get high and they're worth more money, then you get a little bit spewy, but not before. Because I think people suffer in this from being too loose early and then too tight late. It seems like it's pretty common. I mean, I see these players that just seem to play every pot, and then suddenly they play like nits when the blinds get high. I'm like, shouldn't you just do the opposite of that? So if you just do the opposite of that, I think you're fine in these. It's not like an MTT where all the money is kind of at the top, but it's not the same as an MTT where you have to build this giant stack. I mean, if you could just maintain 500 or 600 going into three-handed, I mean, I think you're in good shape in these, because the blinds will generally be like 50, 100, and then, you know, just a couple steals, and suddenly you're either the chip lead or whatever. Or at least second place. You don't have to have this massive stack going into heads up to win either. People play pretty bad heads up, so. But yeah, aggression is definitely the way to go in these. So we have aces. I don't think we slow play. People don't generally ISO fold in these, so I think we just shove. So we run the jacks here. And we hold. So we got doubled up on our first two games. That's a good start. We'll try to parlay these into a couple victories. Get off to a good start here. I think we can raise call it off from this guy, but fold to this guy. And I think just jam. I mean, nobody can bust us here. And unfortunately, we have to call here. We don't run into queens. But I think this is standard here. We still have chips. He couldn't bust us, so I think it's a standard call there. We still get back in this. It's only 25-50. It's okay to take risks when you still have enough chips to have fold equity. In these, especially three-handed. I mean, he's certainly going to have a wider range than just queens plus, right? So certainly this is a shove. Wow, we don't run good in the last couple of these, but looks like we're going to get lucky. Yes. Yes, you got to get lucky sometimes. Maybe we just complete that. Don't need to shove this. If it was 5,100, we would be shoving that. Now we just lead into this pot and expect to take it down almost always here, unless he just happened to flop something. Which I guess he has a 6 or a 3. I'm not going to try and barrel a fish off a 6 or 3 here. So I'm just going to give up on this one. I've learned that a long time ago in these. You just don't have enough behind to run multi-street bluffs against these players. Do we call a shove? This guy's been pretty passive. I don't think we call a shove, but I think we can do this. Just attack the dead money, right? Sometimes you'll get trapped there, but I think it's better just to attack the dead money. We kind of want to have 700 or 800 chips when it comes down to 5,100. I think we can complete, try to hit something big here. This guy's pretty aggro, so he might raise sometimes. I think we just lead. I think he just plays like a cash game in this spot, right? There's going to be a lot of hands that connect with this board. I'm certainly not going to call once we get shoved on. And we'll have to raise call it off with the jacks here. You just don't fold pairs, jacks plus in these. That's a big no-no. If you run into queens, kings, or aces, it's just a cooler. But it's a hyper turbo. You have to get maximum. You just have to get the money in with jacks plus. Just no two ways about it. So I think we check this back and make a decision on turns. I think we just protect now. I'm not trying to get him to fold a king or an ace. I'm just trying to protect against the club. I guess we fold. This guy is shoving here. Assuming he would generally have a strong hand when he does that. don't think we need to shove here. I think it's not enough. There's not enough to win to shove there. And this guy, he's only showing the nuts when he shoves, so I'm not going to call it off. I don't think he's... I mean, he is 3-betting 3 out of 11. That doesn't mean anything. The one time we saw a hand was queens, so I'm just going to give him respect there. Now we're to the point where it's worthwhile with 6 big blinds to shove. And we'll shove very, very wide here. Very, very wide. Wow. Oh, I thought he called. That's pretty funny. We'll just raise and decide. We might have to call it off if we get shoved on here. I think 7 big blinds, we got to put it in with king 9. We fold that. We're just going to fold this. We're going to be nits. Wow, he called with king 10. That's so horrible. Come on, 8. Alright, so we get a little unlucky in this one. This guy called when he wasn't supposed to. He's not supposed to put his terminal in line there with king 10. But we want calls with king 10. I mean, if we have ace deuce there, we definitely want him to call. But it's, I think it's a shove with 7 big blinds. I mean, he's supposed to fold that. I think we just do this here. And I like to shift my tables around. That way we always keep our oldest tables on the top. Wow, really? I'm going to just do this because I don't want to check call. And I think we can check call this river because I think we're just good here. I don't think he ever has a 10, so I think we're good. I think he just had a 4 or 3 or something. Man, I can't breathe. I just did nasal spray, so we're going to let that kick in here in a second. He had pocket 6s? He didn't shove over my limp with that. That's really weird. Why wouldn't he shove over my limp? I don't know. I'm just like, I'm going to shove this. I mean, you just have to chance people trapping you. I mean, if they're trapping, they're trapping. I've got 33% equity here, even if he is trapping. But I think you just got to tag dead money. You got to maintain your stack. I mean, if he happens to be trapping, we've got 400 chips, so it's not the end of the world. I think we'll just go with our ploy. I like to keep pots small. I'm not a big fan of just pounding when you're not playing for much money. This guy's already shown that he just checks back with a 6s, right? So, I don't know what I guess he had to have aces there, but hands this strong, we certainly will just shove because we can't fold to a 3-bet. Just take the easy route. Certainly hoping this guy shoves weak here, which he should be a lot. I guess we'll just do this. I think blind versus blind, we just have to put it in here. I think I have to shove the jack 7 just because I'm so short. I can't let the blinds go through me again here. Jack 7's definitely strong enough to attack. Alright, we're just kind of forced to do this right now. Hopefully we just get it through. Or if we don't get it through, just get a fold. Uh-oh, this guy might call me. He's not getting a great price, so he needs to have a pretty strong hand to do this. Do we peel? So we actually cash one finally here. We have a good position. I almost like to peel in this spot sometimes. This guy is weak sometimes. Sometimes he'll check back turns, and sometimes we'll just spike a 3. Sometimes he'll check back and then we lead the river. I think we just lead the river now. I think he calls with a jack but folds a lot of other hands, so it's fine. And it's okay, I mean, it's fine that he's raising. I don't know that he's necessarily doing that light either. But I think it's better against, it's good to feel that spot out. I have to shove the deuce 4 here, unfortunately. I want to do it quick. I don't want to give him a chance to think about it. Wow. I guess he's got a call with queen 10 there. Just sucks. Deuce. And we'll take the double up. I think 10 big blinds we can shove here. think it's like the minimum hand we need. And we've already saw that limping isn't good, so. So good that blind split up. I will have to shove white on the next hand. I don't know that this guy, let's see if I have any reads. Don't even read, so. Certainly just gonna put it in with ace nine. We just showed the deuce four. I guess we'll fold this one. Eh. If I hadn't shown the deuce four, I would shove that. I don't like to fold that hand because now the blinds are going through me, but I still think we have some fold equity once it goes through. Wow, we get folded to our tens. That sucks. So we only have 55 to call, so we're certainly going to call and try and check it down here. I'm going to try limping again. I may go for some value on the river here. Like just some modicum of value, like a min bet. I'm just going to bet. Oh wow, this guy has two pair. At least I get the side pot, right? this guy is hijack. I think I'll just give him credit. So we basically free rolled it because it got called on the river. So it's fine. I'm just going to keep doing this as long as he allows me to. Yeah, I'm just going to fold now. Ah, nut flush. So we don't lose a player, unfortunately. Kings is nice to have. So I'm just going to do a min raise. We want action, right? Check fold this, I guess. This guy's pretty tight. He's folding to us a lot in the big blind. I don't think we need to attack these limp pots as vigorously. I think he's going to have a fairly strong range when he does that. Could be trapping as well. So we'll just play it close to the vest. We'll certainly shove this hand. I think we just have to call it off here if we get shoved on. Ugh, I don't know, this guy's 33-5. We will fold now just to try and get to... Yeah, okay. I guess so, this guy's gonna bust, right? So that, lead that. We'll definitely get it in with that if he folds. I think we go for another street here. We don't necessarily have to be beat. Wow. Now I guess we're in trouble. Well, this is unfortunate. I mean, at least we had two live cards. We just kind of ran into a monster there, though. We definitely have to shove the 10-8. We're running into big hands. And we're getting called by hands that shouldn't be calling. That's the nature of these. So, he's folding, so that's good. Move this up here. And we'll certainly have to shove the Jack 7 suited. I think we can fold this. I think we would shove the hijack. We have to fold that. It's close. If it was suited, it would certainly be going in. We're not going to play around here. We're going to shove this for the chip lead if he folds. All right, we have a little chip lead now. Okay, we can play with this. Shove it in, buddy. Ah. I guess I'm fine with that, but although we're way ahead of his range. We'd like to get it in with that. We'll keep just applying the pressure here with a big suited queen like this. So... Yep. So now we're just going to shove almost any button here, if he actually folds this. Yeah, we're shoving any button from now on. Assuming we're still going to have 900 chips when we lose. I said any button, right? There's like three hands I won't shove, 9 deuce, 7 deuce, 8 deuce. And that's only the unsuited versions. This guy's 11-11. I guess I'll just give him credit. Alright, there's one we can shove. I expect to get called here fairly often because he's been folding so much, but I guess not. I don't know what this guy's waiting on. I'm sure he's had a hand he could call with. Maybe he's just completely card dead. I don't know, how card dead could you be, right? To not have... Wow. Nice flop. Certainly not continuing on that. How am I going to rep that? That's definitely going in. I was going to consider shoving that, but I guess I can't now. Next hand, I have to shove extremely wide. Can't let the blinds go through me again. We're just kind of stuck here. Yeah, I just got to do it. I hate to, but I got to. I can't believe we haven't gotten all in yet. This is like the freaking... I mean, the blind's going to go up again here. I keep getting all these hands I can shove to. It's like I'm not getting any weak hands. Okay, we can win this. Just have to avoid some kind of shenanigans, and I think we win, right? No shenanigans, so we win our first one. So that's good. It's good to win. It's nicer to win a lot, but we'll take our first win of the day. Think there's any way to slow play ace queen here. Wow, every time I have a shoving hand, somebody shoves before I can. Is this a table of regs here? I guess it is. It's a good thing I didn't, because I would have lost. Definitely got to shove the king three. This is like a premium hand right here, considering the situation. I'll take a king high any day in this spot. Alright, that's a good result. I don't know how the blinds are this high with four-handed. Actually, this is weird. Yeah, I think these are three competent players here, so this is going to be a tough one to win here. It's going to take a little bit of luck. So I don't think they're misplaying too often. This guy's going to shove extremely wide. How does he have queen four? How does he call that hand? My god, man. That's so horrible. Okay, well. Well, we're definitely putting it in here with the ace six suited. Hopefully we triple, quadruple up here. Get back in it. Okay, this is a monster. We have the best hand, had the best hand. Need an ace or a six. Alright, so we're definitely putting it in with the ace jack, because this guy's shoving really wide. I expect him to have like just a lot of crap, right? Uh-oh. Oh, okay, that's not so bad. Ah! It wasn't so bad until this guy binked. That was a triple up just waiting to happen there. We'll take a random hand in the big blind here. It's hard to beat those two hands. I mean, we're only like a 40% favor there. Okay, we'll take that random hand. That's a good one. Okay, this guy was supposed to just complete, but he's folded when he wasn't supposed to, so that's good. Just need to hold here and get back in this. Alright, there's step one. Step two is to win another one. Alright, we'll take this. Got a chance here to get back in this. This guy's supposed to just limp here and then check it down. Alright. Just high cards, please. Now he's drawing dead. That's good. Alright. Back in it. He'll be shoving just about any two on this button as well. I don't know. This guy's pretty desperate. Now it's 100, 200. I think I can fold. Ah! This guy's going to have to call it off with anything here, so I can't really shove 7-5. Of course, 7-5 would have been good, right? Dagnabbit. Yeah, just got to put it in with 7-8 now. I have some fold equity. It's possible some people could fold. Possible. Okay, we'll take a flip. 9-7 or 8, please. That's not it, so we're out. It's a little bit unlucky, but that was above average quality of play on that table. That's not what we're looking for. Whatever. Chop it up. I guess we raise again. Do we call it off from this player? Probably not. Wow, another one of these nitty tables. That's not good. At least we're picking up hands, right? The knit raises, the knit folds. We have to shove yet. Same guy that just raised on a 9-9-8 earlier. Maybe this isn't the best ploy against him. We'll just assume he had a 9 or an 8 earlier. Fool me twice type thing. Lose another player. Check, 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 check. Wow, maybe two players. How about an ace? Nope. Nope. We almost were three-handed. I don't really like all the money to my left, but I guess he's not need. I mean, maybe he'll be tight enough that he'll realize that he can't call, still can't call light. I don't know. I don't know. So we'll just play. Ouch! The 10 comes in. I guess we're down 3 now. It's like we'd have a dead small blind every hand in this game. So we have the second biggest chip stack, but there's a long way to go here. I mean, the blinds are low. Barring a cooler between those two players. Now this guy is pretty tight, so I like our situation here. He's just going to be folding a lot. I guess we can be folding a lot. I'm assuming this player will pound on this guy's blind a lot, and so I like our relative position here. Like our chances. They can't fold now. Oh, we get a little domination nation. I kind of like this guy's shove just because this guy's going to be a lot wider than king queen here. I like the king nine. I like his thought process, and I like the fact that we just cashed. And we'll certainly not call that because he's probably got a king. Fold that, and we'll just get it in with the ace four. Hopefully we can hold on this and get into this thing. Need a four, a paired board or something. High card, please. That is not a high card. Just needed anything above that. All right, we'll take a second place. Not the end of the world. I would prefer, what I would prefer is to win that hand, but beggars can't be choosers. Kind of good to get a second place in. Stab at this one. Hard for him to have something. What the? What you call him with? Okay, so we got a little fishy into our right here. I gotta play his fishy game. Unless we had a boat or a flush. Then I'll play his fishy game. Excuse me. Welcome to those just joining. If you don't know, I am sick. I have this head cold that won't go away. So we're playing these low variants. Well, high variants, low variants. They're low variants for me. They're lower variants with me playing 200 NL today. I just don't have the mental fortitude, I don't think, today to play my normal game. So we're just playing these for kind of fun and just something to do. Rather than just taking the day off, which I certainly could have done. So we're getting in the... Ugh. Okay, we got a chance here. How about a king? I guess there's only one king in the deck, right? But we're still in it. That's going to happen sometimes. All right, we can get back in it right here. Yeah, sometimes you just get coolered. There's nothing you can do about it. I'm assuming these guys will probably both call, but I'm just going to give one of them a chance to fold here so I can be heads up. Can't really just check back. Okay, get what we want. Why does he have to have a heart draw? Huh. So gross. That's all he has. That's all he has. And I even had a heart. Very disgusting. Fold that. I guess we just shove the 360 here. Raise that. So we're kind of running assy today so far, but that's okay. We'll win a bunch in a big cluster here soon. I guess we just do this. I mean, maybe he misclicks and we still... Now we force him to get the money in? I don't know. Yeah, decent sized pot for no flop. I know I like my ace 10, but not anymore. I liked it until this shenanigans happened. I'll definitely call that shenanigans. Wow. Just puts it in with a king 9. Hit a 9! We want you in this. I guess we'll take the low variance route here. And we'll shove the deuces just because it's a pair. Certainly never folding this pre-flop. And yes, we do not really want called with the deuces. Unless somebody's got like ace-deuce. Then we'll take a call. Wow. Wow! He actually flopped that. Can I pair the board? What the hell just happened? What the hell was that? People flopping straights when I hit sets? I'm just glad I'm still in it. I mean, what the hell was that? I don't mind his call just because he's so short, but can that not happen, please? Well, this guy's pretty loose. I think we can shove this. Ugh. So gross. Of course we hit the ace when it's no good, right? We're just running bad. What are you gonna do? Keep playing, I guess. That's all you can do. Shenanigans! I mean, I guess I could just flat there, but I'm probably gonna go all in on that flop anyway, so I guess it doesn't really matter. Maybe not, I don't know. We unfortunately have to put it in with a king, queen, queen, nine here. We can't fold. Oh, of course. Oh, boy. That's crazy. I mean, just have ace, king or something, right? This is what variance looks like, guys. We will eventually win another all-in, I swear. It's possible. We're not going to slow play. Wow, why does it have to be a flip? If he's going to make a horrible call, why can't he make a horrible call when he's not at least flipping? And once again, variance. What is he calling with queen 10? I don't understand. I mean, I like the call. I'd rather him call with queen 10 when we have ace queen, not when we have tens. So we'll fold this. Wow. We'd like to win it all in here eventually. And we're just getting some weird calls. I mean, queen jack. I guess my image is pretty bad. That's the worst thing, is when somebody makes a really bad call and they get rewarded with a flip. I hate that. Can't they make a bad call with fours or something? Of course, we had the guy call with 6-5, right? He still hit a flush on us. We'll fold that. We're not going to get jiggy with a deuce 4 suited. And we're not. I guess we could complete there. Heh! good for you to waste your aces. So we're three-handed here. I mean, that's solid, right? We have a chance. Blinds aren't going up for another minute, so we can fold that. We're going to bink this one to get this thing back on track here. We could sometimes shove the king 8 there. Certainly would if it was 5100. I don't think we slow play this. I think we just shove. We just go after the 100 that's out there. We don't want him to get a free cheap price with his 6 queen or whatever, or his 9-7, 9-8. Let's make him put it all in if he wants to see all 5 cards or 4 cards or whatever. Showed me aces last time. I folded. Okay, blinds are up just in time for us to shove this. We'll have to call it off with the ace 10 here. I think we have to still stick it in here. I mean, it's a little fishy when he just raises, but I think we have to. Okay, we'll take a flip. Can we win a flip? Yes, we can win a flip. Oh, I spoke too soon. Man, I thought we were finally gonna win one. That is freaking amazing. Well, at least we got ace king here. Let's go out with a blaze of glory. That's pretty sick. He hits a 3! This guy can't lose. Holy cow. Wow, I just feel like we just got screwed out of like at least $10 there. The drought continues. Have we won any all-ins in like the last 5 or 6 of these? I think we've lost everything. I don't think we've won it all in since that heads up where we won that one, or have we? I don't know. I don't know. I mean, that can happen, right? I guess it's better to have it happen here than in 200 and L to lose like 8 straight all ins or whatever. I thought for sure we had the ace 10 when we spiked the 10. We had a 95% chance, right? Thought our fortunes were turning. Basically chip leader, almost chip leader with heads up. If it's multi-way, we may call the fours here. Probably fold otherwise. I guess we'll fold now. What, no 4? Where's my 4? Guess it wouldn't matter now. So for those of you just joining, I have a cold. Still raging, so I'm taking the lower variance, lower buy-in route today and just playing these for kind of fun. I could take the day off, but I've taken enough days off recently, I need to start playing again, so I'm trying to ease into the week by playing these. And we've just... I've won one and had a second, but we're running like ass otherwise in these. I mean, it's just ridiculous, we're losing every all-in. So, I mean, I guess I'd rather run bad in these, though, like I said, than the cash games, right? So, I mean, it's bound to happen, these are hyper-turbos, I mean, all you gotta do is just... hit a one patch of variance and you can lose like 10 of these in a row. We're going to hang tough here. I know I can win these in clusters. I won 4 straight the other day, so it can happen. I mean, our graph in these is pretty good. That's my, my SNG graph right there. Not too bad, right? I've seen worse. It's like 40-something percent ROI. I don't know. Which I'm assuming is pretty good. I just don't know. Maybe somebody can tell me out there what a good ROI is for these. Yeah, it's 45.6% is my ROI, which sounds good to me. I mean, I wouldn't. I mean, I think that's pretty lousy for MTTs, but I don't know if this is worth attacking here. I think I can raise fold this. I don't think it's good enough to shove though, at this level. Pretty crappy flop. I think we check back to try and pick up some equity or just fold. If he donk bets, which is going to happen often on this board. Yeah, we'll just fold. It's only 55, but I mean, if we had the ace of hearts, we might peel there, but I think it's better just to conserve. I think he's just going to have 9, 10, or an 8 here a lot. And yeah. Oh man. Wow, he wins with a six kicker. I mean, who limps a pair blind versus blind? That's so horrible. I mean, I could see him doing that with like tens plus to trap. The sixes is just horrible because you're inducing some hands like Jack 10 suited, which are actually maybe slightly ahead of you, to shove as well. And that's not really what you want. You just kind of want to take the blinds there, I think. People get rewarded for their bad play. And it's been kind of that over and over again. I mean, I haven't really gotten it in dominated that much. I'm just losing a lot that I should be winning. Losing a bunch of flips. Finding weird ways to lose hands. I'm trying not to keep track of how many I've lost in a row, but it's been a lot. Definitely have to shove this with only 400 blind versus blind. Even though he's got 300, I think I still have fold equity because I think he still has 300 chips and it's only 2550. So I think I have to maintain my stack there. I think it's a good spot blind versus blind because I'm just going to win that like 90% and probably fold. Now I have queen jack, watch. Ha! Told you you'd have queen jack. Deuce, deuce, deuce. Ugh. Oh, this is getting frustrating, guys. There's our 1,000 chip pot we just won. Should be over 1,000 chips here, but instead, Donkosaurus Rex here has 930. Well, at least we have some chips to play with. We're not out of this yet. Definitely don't have to put it in right now. We'll be a little bit patient. I mean, that's like the second triple up, too, where we were a big favorite. So I will be shoving the Jack 9 suited here and the 7s. Not now. Yeah, we'll just put it in. This guy's going to call with anything, so hopefully he has like 6-5 and not 9 Jack or whatever. Ace 9, there's the 9. I mean, there's the ace. Wow. Another one we can't win. Man, this is getting old. Getting really freaking old. Some days you feel like you can't lose, and other days, man, like today, so far, can't win anything. Surprising this guy folded, but we're ahead of his range there, so random hand, right? We certainly have to shove that. It's pretty sure we have to call here. Yep, we have to call here. We're way ahead of him. Ugh. What? We're even going to lose this one? Oh my god. I mean, at least it's a small pot, but man. This is insane. It's just like we don't even have a sniff at winning any of these. We're like drawing dead instantly on these hands. I guess we just have to fold this. We're putting it in no matter what. If this guy shoves or whatever, it's going in. The only way we can win a pot is if everybody just folds. Alright. Well, maybe we'll win 8 or 10 straight all-ins now and then get back in this. Alright, money's going in no matter what. We have less than 3 big blinds. We'll definitely get it in versus this guy because he could have anything here. We're way ahead of this guy's shoving range, I think. If he has king queen beat, it's just a cooler. If he does, it's with like ace five or something. Ace jack. Again, we lose a frickin' flip. My god, man. I swear that has that like 12 straight we've lost. I don't even know the math on this. I mean, it's ridiculous. This guy just called this board. Wow. Holy crap. This is kind of almost outside the realm of variance now. I mean, it's crazy. Not paying that guy off. Even for 20. I don't know, man. If I win an all-in here, I don't care if it's aces versus anything. I might get up and just dance in celebration. Got to get some positive vibes going here. Have a little bit of rally and luck. Maybe I should have just taken a day off. Wow. All right, queens. Here we go. This is going to start the landslide of run good here. All right, kings. Here we go. Let me get back in this session. I doubt that an under-the-gun opening is ever going to fold, so let's just get it in there. We're going to win both these, and we're going to win both of these sit-and-goes. All right. Here we go. Deuce. Deuce. Wow, we won! Celebrate. All right, the streak is over. I don't know what that streak was, but it was a lot. It was, what, 10 or 12 straight all-ins? I don't even know. Now we're going to put this in. Let's win another one. All right. Short-lived, wasn't it? Wow. All right, at least we got one of them. Something to build on. Why couldn't we just win both of those? God. What is this guy just calling it off with King 10 for? I mean, obviously he knows he's crushed. It's like the worst hand he's ever going to see there is like sevens. I'm going to have like Ace King, King Queen, Ace Queen, Ace Jack, all the big pairs. But I'm never going to have worse than King 10. He's got like 35% equity versus my range or worse, and he's just putting it in. No, I don't think we slow play this. I think we just shove. He's got better than ace-10 suited. It's cooler. But we're still in it if he does. Certainly can get called by worse there. King, jack, queen, queen, any of those hands, right? And we're just going to do the same thing. Wish the blinds were higher right now. That'd be nice. Instead of just winning these paltry little 45 chips, but I guess it's better than nothing. We do not have to call it off with the king 8 here. Don't have to shove that. Well, maybe we do. I guess technically we call this, right? We have to. Maybe we win this. Maybe we win a nice little pot. How about a deuce on the turn? I guess just this is fine. I mean, this is like announcing, hey, everybody, have a monster. Crap, I can't overshove. Great. I'm not gonna check it down with this guy. Alright. We won another one. Knocked a guy out in the process, that's good. Not sure why this guy is betting with just a 6 here. It's pretty dumb. Worked out for him. We're definitely putting it in with this 6 big blinds here, no matter what the action is. We'd have to double up. Can't let a hand this strong get by. Heart. Alright, and then chop it up. And this guy's never folding, so this has to be a monster here. Ace 3. Hit a 3! Alright. Double him up. Ooh, 10s. This guy had 500 or less, we'd just be shoving preflop. I'm thinking everybody's in knock this guy out mode, so I think I could just raise any two cards here. And I think if these guys realize that, they can just shove on me with any two cards, but people shouldn't be playing tight here, but I think they are. Just because there's a guy close to being knocked out, which shouldn't be relevant because you still have to... You're still not in the money if he gets busted, right? But people have that mentality. Is when somebody's short, they don't want to be the next one out. Alright, can we do it? Can we win another all-in? Alright, looks like we just locked this one up. Alright, so we have a pretty good chip lead here, three-handed. Hopefully we can parlay this into a win. It's close. This guy's pretty tight, though. We've done this twice to this guy, but he apparently is just 13-0. So it's fine. We'll be shoving this with any two cards, I think. King 4 is more than good enough. King, please. Just all I need is a king. Just a king. Come on. Ah, we were back in that. All we had to do was hit a king. Those are the ones that are nice to win. Seems like a distinct impossibility. Alright, we can go with the ace 10 here. This guy's going to be shoving fairly wide, so I can just stick it in with the ace 10. We flip-flop spots if I happen to lose this, but I think I'm ahead of his range, so... Yep. Come on. Do you have to give him spade draws? For crying out loud. It's just ridiculous. I'm just going to keep applying the pressure when they have like 7 or 8 big blinds. Definitely have to shove this with a king high. We're ahead of his range. He's going to have to call this with any two cards, so we're just going to put it in. Wow. Strange fold. This guy should be shoving really wide here. Really wide. Fortunately, I can't do anything with Jack 3. Definitely can shove the King 10 here. This guy has to have a super premium hand to call since this guy's down the 4. He should have like at least Ace Queen to call there. He should be folding Ace Jack. He should be folding 8s, you know. So that's a good spot for us. Besides that, we have a friggin' strong hand. I would be able to call pretty wide here, but this guy's pretty tight. Pretty tight. I will be shoving the King 7, though. This guy's gonna be shoving wide again. Wow, that's a monster when he does that. Wow, why couldn't you call that one? This guy's got to shove just about any two cards here. Yeah, that's a big mistake. I don't know whether he's showing Queen 7 because he would have called, or whether it's because he would have folded. I don't know. This would be a huge mistake for this guy to shove here. I think he's supposed to either limp or raise fold. That actually looks pretty strong. But I have Ace 10. What am I going to do? Fold? Thought it looked strong. Come on, Jack. Jack, please, club. I mean, it's okay because I still have chips, but it's just annoying that he would pick up that strong of a hand right there. Okay, we just have to hold again. Just no eights, baby. No clubs. What have I got to say? I mean, what is going on here? It's like whatever the worst card in the deck is out there comes. I just went from the massive chip lead to out of this thing almost. Oh, man. I'm supposed to be winning this one a lot of the time. Okay, we'll take a little bit of protection here. All right, King, please, make it easy on me. Don't give him an open-ended. Godly. It tried to bust me. We're definitely folding the ace-jack here. All right, we have a good situation here. A very strong hand versus his random two cards. Alright, just have to void a joker or three, and he gets both. Alright, seven or ace or five. Just give him a boat. Just give him a boat. Just give him a boat. This cockroach here. Oh. I really want to win this one. I'm so sick of losing everything. This guy's just sitting back, just enjoying the show. We're crushing him. No clubs. Deuce! Alright, I'll take a win. Now, I don't really care about... This is the one I have to win, is the next one. Alright, good. At least this guy's attacking his blinds. At least I get to sit out on all in this time, right? So I have to shove just about any two cards on this next hand here. Yeah, that's got to go in for sure. Good luck us. This has got to go in. Okay, we got a hold here. Hold. All right. Back in the chip lead. All right, just need a king or an eight, please. King or eight? Nope. Man, that would have been nice too. Guess I have to shove the queen four here. Against the guy that can't lose all ends. Come on, no jack or eight, please. Alright. At least I get a chop, right? He can't lose, but at least I don't lose money, right? So this has to go in, so. And this guy's got a call, so. Here we go. How about a three? Just so we can get heads up. There's cockroach, man. I swear he's a cockroach. It's actually a really bad spot for us, because this guy's going to fold, he's going to shove, and I have to fold. I have to call. Three or five. Three or five. No. This is getting borderline ridiculous here. All right, here we go. Not the guy that can't lose. Oh, he even had diamonds. Oh, I can't believe that shit. The cockroach. That was a 2,000 chip pot. I'm like, that just cost me like 20 bucks there. Man, when that diamond hit the turn, I thought I was going to actually win it. I was lulled into a false sense of security, I guess. Okay, let's keep pounding. That's about all we can do, right? That's painful. Oh, really painful. Wow. So many good spots in that thing, too. This is a really good spot here. Ace Jack's way ahead of these guys' raising ranges. Or limping ranges. Simple shove here. And we're not going to sit back on our laurels here. We're going to keep trying to build a stack here. We'd like to get this. We'd like to be chip lead, obviously, but, you know, we're not going to shove the 10-9. Wow, these guys are nits. Maybe we should have shoved that. We can call this for sure. Yeah. Is he going to keep limping? If he's going to keep limping, I'm going to keep shoving. Looking good for the home team here. Alright. In good shape again in three-handed. These are the spots that we normally just could take these down. We can raise call it off from this guy. But having them both phone is frickin' fantabulous. I'm not gonna shove if this guy limps again. That's not a possibility. So I guess we just need to cooperate to get this guy out. So that's what we're gonna try and do here. Not quite good enough hand here. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to put it in here for the next couple hands. This guy's sitting out too, that's what's kinda gross. Wow. Can this guy get knocked out? And then this some guy somehow. I think we raise here. We can raise fold to this guy. I think if I could just win this one, this guy's sitting out here. I think we'll try and check it down. Oh, man. This is so gross. How does he have that hand? Wow. Wow, he has a nuts? I mean, come on. This guy's sitting out, too. That's what's gross. If I can just get through that hand. I mean, can I find a fold on that hand? I don't think so, right? I have to try and get some chips because I don't have the guy that's sitting out covered yet. This is getting annoying. Guess I have to fold 6-8. Gross. Should be shoving 100% here. Okay. Ace 5 just got a hold. It doesn't look like it's going to. Series of unfortunate events. Here we are, somehow in third place again. Not looking good. Can't even get the heads up anymore. Can we even shove this? Because this guy's just got a call. I guess he doesn't have to call. Alright, that helps. I guess we have to shove this button, though. Alright. We have to. We just have to. I mean, we don't need to second guess this. Just do it. I mean, they've got to pick up a hand to call, and we can't just let the blinds go through us again. We're not playing for second here. We're playing to win this thing. Alright, I guess we're committed to this. I think he checks this turn a lot. I just don't know. Can we call this? Because what are we going to have left if we don't hit? I guess we have enough to get it in next hand. So gross, because now we have to fold? How do we not improve on this board? Should I just put it in on the flop? I guess not, because at least we have some chance of still cashing in this. What do we do there? I mean, we're kind of just screwed there. If we don't get there, we're kind of just screwed. Can't fold the flop. I don't know. Do we just put it in on the flop? I don't know. Wow. I didn't actually want to fold there, but we'll take it. Okay. Can we get called by like ace-10 here? Now we're the cockroach, right? Okay, jacks. Deck's kind of hitting us in the face here. Wow, he doesn't limp that one. I guess we just bet fold here. How blinds are up. God bless it. There, we got kings down there. No! God, and of course we're drawing dead pretty much on the flop. Oh well. I mean, we just play the way we have to, right? Wow! I think we're going to win this one. Now we just need to be able to follow through and continue and win the thing. I feel like we just lost. We just had like $40 snatched from our hands. With those two, we were three-handed with chip lead. So gross. How are we not winning those? It's like normally I would expect to win those. We have been winning those when I get that deep. Oh well, you guys all witnessed it. We can't win the ones we have to win, and I guess that's just what it boils down to. The ones that knock somebody out, we can't win. I think we go after this 75 right here. This guy's got to call really tightly. So. We're going to keep applying pressure. I mean, if they shove, we'll just fold. Easy peasy. No, I don't want to leave the table. What are you talking about? I never said I wanted to leave the table. We'll check back the gut shot here. I think we can rep that turn card. Good chance we have the best hand here, so no point in betting, I guess. Wow, do we just have the best hand here most of the time? What the hell does this guy have? How do you have... Oh, I guess he had a diamond. I don't know. Do we just have to call this? Wow. Okay. I guess that makes sense. Maybe I shouldn't be making thin calls on these just because people don't ever have... You know, maybe they're just not bluffing as much in these. Maybe that's just an error on my part. Do we just have to fold this? King-jack, I guess. I'm definitely not folding the king-queen here. Oh, wow. Really? You have ace-king? How does this guy have ace-king? Did he raise preflop? I guess maybe he did. He min-raised. Yeah. I'm still fine with that. We actually got there one time. That was pretty cool. Maybe this is the one that'll... Maybe we'll just win every one of these now. I guess we're beating... Are we just tying a random hand here? I guess. I don't know. We actually have the best hand now that he's thinking about it, so we want to call. Please call. You can't fold, dude. You got, like, all your stacks in the pot. All right. Guess we could fold that. Maybe I'm just really bad at these. Maybe I'm not running bad. I'm just really bad. How about some positive variants today? There's my queen four. That wouldn't have helped. Oh, this one's already... Wait, never mind. I misread the table dynamic here. Okay. Yeah, we gotta put it in. Sucks, but we gotta do it. We gotta shove this one too. If this guy could stay sitting out, that'd be pretty good for us. Oh, wow. I don't want him sitting out now. At least we have the best hand here so far. Did we hold? I think we held. Just gonna call here. I think this guy's shoving wide because this guy was sitting out, but now he's back, so good thing he was still sitting out when the guy shoved. We got the run into the threes. No diamond on the turn. Hey, we got 2,000 chips. Awesome. It's a good spot here. Can we just hold in one of these spots? Can we just... Nope. Apparently we cannot. So sick. Just win that one and we got a massive chip lead again. I don't think we have to go too crazy here. Do we just put pressure? I think when you get this big of a chip lead, you're going to have the chip lead heads up, so you just kind of want these guys to just snuff each other out. King or a three, please. I guess a three won't help. Got to do something down here pretty soon. Oh, do you have to hit the jack? Hits the jack and the ace. Another squandered opportunity up here, it looks like. Can we hold? Okay, we're back in that one. Whoa, I don't want to be sitting out. I should have probably put that in, I'm not sure. I don't think you do anything but shove here and here. I think I'll take a random hand there. Wow, blinds got so high four-handed here. It's really weird. I think we have to call this... Oh, well, spades, please. I get free-rolled. This is just freaking crazy. How many times can this happen? I'm going to go for it here. Fold that. Do that. Yeah, that's why I wanted to do that. I guess we just go for it here. I mean, we just kind of have to double up, and we have guaranteed heads up, so even though we're not beating a random hand, and he flops the nuts, and we're just drawn dead. I mean, that's par, right? I think we have to call this. Yep. Looks like he's drawing pretty thin. Alright, another 2,000 chip. 2,000 chips to squander. We just cannot get the heads up. This is just getting borderline ridiculous here. We have to call this. Can we just win this? Can we win this? I think we did. Wow. And we won that one. Okay, this guy's... Apparently we're heads up here. Wow, this guy turned it. We just can't get the heads up. I can't believe this. We're heads up here, though. Be a little bit patient here. I have to call that. We have triple. Oh, he actually has a flush. I can't. This is unbelievable. How bad we're running right now. I can't believe he actually had the flush. Why does it have to give us trips? This guy limps. We're shoving. We have to call that. We're ahead. Let's hold. Deuce, please. Deuce. Deuce. Oh, my God. I guess we fold that. We actually won this one, so that's good. We're holding here. Hold here. Nope. Can't hold. We're out. God, that was another first. We could have just won. All right, let's think here. I think this guy's going to be shoving pretty l tight, so I think I can fold king 8. Wow, I think I sh we should have just won this one down here too. We had it up until the river. All right, we'll definitely take jacks here. Chance to get back in this. All right, so this is the last couple we'll register here. I think we may register this one if it ends fairly quickly. And then that would be it. We'll be done after that. Just have to avoid a king. And the king magically comes, as always. And we can't get there. Once again, another three-handed one where I felt like we just left money on the table. We had 2,000 chips on that one at one time. We did get one win and one second in that little set, though. And that basically makes up for six losses, but we don't want to just break even. We want to make money. So we're not going to register any more of these. We're just going to play these out. May the Schwartz be with us. How could you be raising here? What do you have, Jack 4? I guess a weak ace, I don't know. Probably have the best hand here. Fortunately, this guy just donk bets. And we just don't have any room. See, normally on a cash game, I would just raise this and he's gonna fold, but if I'm wrong here, I think I can just peel though. It's a really good card for us. It's hard for him to have an ace. I just can't continue though. I mean, he's just able to just donk bet his way into a victory there. He should be checking that turn a lot. But I just think he had air and was just bluffing. I mean, there's nothing I can do about it. Do I really want to just shove my king 3 when there's much better spots to win against that type of player? I probably should just be folding the flop there, honestly. Okay, like nothing's going on all of a sudden. Is this a hyper turbo? Okay, we got our fourth one up here. I guess we just check back. Think we just min raise this, and I think he folds a lot. Should hate this board a lot, right? Yeah. Definitely shoving this. Wow. Did I actually get there one time? This guy slow plays his ace-3 like he's trapping. I think when I shove there, he's just beat most of the time. It's nice to win one, though. Screw it. Alright, we're gonna win all four of these, right? These are the spots I'm a little unclear on in hyperturbos. Am I supposed to just go with this? I don't know. I think on the turn we just call, right? We could certainly just have the best hand right now. Probably not now, though. I don't think there's any other play here. Or here. We can just safely fold that now. So we check shove this. This might be a bet fold here. I guess queen 10 could get it in, queen 8. Wow. Do we just shove the turn now? I guess we do. Hey, thank you very much for the follow. I do appreciate that. And we hold. I think we just go for a check call now. I mean, if somebody's got a flush, I think we're just kind of screwed here. Yeah, I mean, this just sucks. I think somebody's got a flush here most of the time. I don't think we can fold, though. I think we just have to try and get back in this. I don't think we can fold that. I don't know why he's betting there, but more power to him. We actually had something good for it go our way here. Now we have kind of the nuts here, and I think they're going to put it in very light. I probably could have limped that, honestly, and got a shove. Doesn't matter, we still got it in. Now we just need to hold. And wow, we do. Okay. Three-handed here, chip lead here. Best hand here going into the flop. Best hand on the turn. Best hand on the river. All right. We're doing good in at least three of these. I'm feeling it. We're going to win all four. You heard it first here. We're going to go 4 for 4 to end this thing and probably still be down for the day, but we'll at least feel better about ourselves, won't we? Got fish, a bunch of fish on this one, so we could just get a little lucky. We can win that one too. I think we just do this. This guy's pretty tight. I think he just checks back and then folds the flop, right? Unless he hits something. And so we're down to four-handed here. These guys are so tight. I think we just raise here. Can raise fold versus these guys. Wow, I think we'll just conserve. I think it's fine. Wow, these guys are a lot looser than I thought they would be. I don't know if we call this or not. I guess not. Yeah, we'll maintain our 1,000 chips here. Okay, I guess we can fold now. I was gonna check shove the flop. I think we just do this. It's kind of fishy this got a limp. But I think we have to attack the dead money. Certainly go after this. I think we'll just fold a 9 high here. It's a little loose, a little tight, but I think we can do it. I guess we just shove this, fold this, and shove this. Time you're under 10 big blinds, it's hard to go wrong. It's almost, you almost can't be too wide there. A little conservative here. I don't know this guy's necessarily attacking very often. Wow. Man. I just expected him to either call or fold. I guess, do we just peel one street and just keep our chips? I don't think we go after it here on the bubble. I think if we don't hit a flush, we just check fold. I think this guy's just going to have two pair or a 10 a lot. So, I mean, I really just think we're getting it in there hoping for a flush. I just don't think that's right on the bubble. I just think you have to fold. The blinds are still low enough. I have 6 big blinds here. I'm fine. We'll fold that. It's just weird that he... I guess I should have just shoved preflop, honestly, right? It's probably a shove preflop. That was a little bit too tight of me to just call that hand. Yeah, I think that's the error. That was the error. That's the ticket. I mean, of course, if he just folds there on the flop, it's... Or I hit a flush on the turn, all is well, right? These guys are just going to be relentless, I can tell. I'm just going to shove every time. So we're going to have to be aggressive. That's why I should have been so aggressive blind versus blind, because this guy is so aggressive. I don't think we can afford to pussyfoot around there. See, now I have to fold this. We hit our king. We hit a straight here, and we win both of these. Wow, okay. That's what I said, we're going to win both of these, or all 4 of these. I think we can gamble a little bit here. I think we have to fold this and just go with the next hand. This guy has to call really tightly, so this guy's the one I'm really targeting here, and that's a good hand. So I think I can just... That was like the perfect attack spot. Oh, does he have to hit the freaking 3? Brutal, man. Brutal, man. Our dream of winning all 4 just died. Alright. All we can do is continue forward. Why does he have to hit the damn set? I guess we have to call for 70 chips. We had 2 live cards there. Wow. This is a bad spot. And we don't spike, so we have to get lucky here to win this one. That sucks. Okay. Just got to avoid a 7 or a deuce, and he hits a 7. I hit a 10, though. The dream is still alive. I'll take a random hand over that, so we have no fold equity. Come on, king, 8, 7, diamond. All right, that works. What did they chop? Oh, yeah, the ace. I'm still going to fold this. I'm going to be knit. I think our random hand has to be better than that. Alright, we'll take the king high. Wow, I guess we'd have to call this too. He's drawing really thinly. Dead. Oh, I meant to call there. Alright, we'll take 2 live cards. Can we just hold this one and be heads up? No club. We'll get it in with a 9-8 suited. Alright, ahead again. Hold. Hold. I can't believe that 7. I thought we were going to chop there. Instead, I lose. That's frustrating. I mean, we're like getting worst case scenario in every single one of these. Have you noticed that? It's like we're getting in really good position, and then it's just like we lose all the key hands. We're gonna win this one and this one though. I think he can fold. I think he can fold. If he had like 400, we would just fold to that. But I think he can fold, so we can shove. We have to have some fold equity when we shove that, right? I don't think we're going to have the right price here. He's got to shove any two, but he's tight. Okay, can we hit a 10 or 4? Nope. We'll just give it to him. I think this is a trap a lot of the time. Can he be that tight? Did he get a limp there? Alright, we'll deal with sixes here. This is where he has sevens, right? And it just the wheels come off right now. Okay, we can win a flip. I don't think we've won a flip today, have we? Doesn't seem like it. Either we've been behind in one, or we've been like super ahead in one. Yeah, all we have to do is win one flip. Now we have ace king. Can we hit a jack or eight? Can we win? Nope. So like I said, wheels come off. We had this guy basically just dead, right? Dead to rights. But he's tight enough that maybe we can get back in this. We still have chips, so it's not over. It just kind of sucks that we just can't have already won this. Why are we having to struggle to win this? Now we just have to hit a jack or four. Near instant drawing dead. Instant drawing dead. When he has the best hand, he's just gonna win. But when we have the best hand, they find ways. So frustrating. I feel like we left like 5 wins on the table today that we normally would win or should have won or had a really good chance to win. So yeah. What are you gonna do? This guy didn't put it in? What the hell? But we'll just chalk this up to just a bad day. I mean, shit happens, right? We did have a few caches. We had a couple wins, right? Did we just have... We had 2 wins, right? I think. I don't know. We're going to win this one, so it doesn't matter. There's a big difference between a win and a second, right? It's like double. So it really hurts when you have a majorly big chip lead and you somehow lose. I think the play is to call here and just try to check it down with this guy. Hopefully a jack peels here and we just have like a... We could just end this right now if a 7 or jack comes, right? Let's just get this thing over with. 7 or jack right now, or queen. God dang it. I wanted an easy one. We just can't get an easy one. Wow, in this worst case scenario, nobody busts. So sick. How does nobody bust there? This guy is tight. Both these guys are tight. I think we can just open the button here. I'm going to take a little risk here, but I think it's fine. Now with 2 overs and a gut shot, I guess we just have to put the money in. We don't want to be calling it off, though. I think we have to fold. I think we have to keep our fold equity. We would want to shove there if he checks, but we can't call it off. How do we get worst case scenario again? Or maybe I should just fold preflop. I don't know. Now we'll lose this one and be like at 200 chips, right? Oh, wow. That's a little gift. Why is this guy folding? I don't know. That was funny, though. What can he fold there? So we're still in a really good spot here. We have we're four-handed and we're in second place in good position. We're obviously not folding if anybody shoves here. Hopefully we can get lucky and win this. Alright, queen or seven. Let's get to three-handed with a good amount of chips here. God. These are the ones we're not winning. Okay. Well, I guess if we're gonna go to the felt, we're gonna do it with a strong hand. Right now. Of course, this guy can fold. Queen or ten. Queen or ace, I mean. Oh, wow. We actually won that. Wow. Oh, man. That's so funny. We had a lot of outs. I mean, whatever, right? Six outs. No fours. All right. We're basically heads up here now. We just need this guy to somehow lose an all-in. I think the play is just to call here. I'm just going to get it in. I mean, if this guy's willing to put it in with just a heart or an eight deuce or whatever, let's let him do it now. Let's. No, 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 no! Oh, my God. Ugh. How does that happen? This guy's got like 1% equity. At least we got the side pot, but... Are you serious that he won that pot? I guess I shouldn't be complaining. I mean, I hit the gut shot, so... Oh, man. So we just went from an automatic sure heads up to now we have to fight for it. That's so frustrating. I mean, I literally don't know if that guy... How much equity did he have? Okay, we just got a jack or nine. Now I know king or four, and we're heads up. Alright, we actually finally, we did get the heads up, although we don't have the chip lead like we should have. We'll get this in, though. Yeah, looks like it's going in. Could we just hold here? Alright, just need to hold. How about a three right now? Okay, he's drawn dead. Alright, we got the chip lead. Let's win this mother. Wow, blinds went up. I guess I have to shove this. Hopefully he's not willing to just put it in with anything here. Alright. How about aces right here? Let's just get this over with. That's good enough for me. This is a monster heads up in this situation. How does he have an ace? So frustrating, man. He just happens to have an ace there. We could have still won that, you know. Right? So it's going to come down to 8-7. Oh, he folds. Okay. Ugh. Well, little gift here from him. He should be shoving almost any two there. We're back to even here. Alright, that's a monster for being able to shove the button. He's being pretty selective here. By the way, that guy actually had 3% equity. I'm surprised on that 5-3 board. Surprised he had that much equity. Alright, here we go. King or three. Why does he have to hit the three? Ace. Oh, another freaking second. Oh well. We'll chalk it up to a bad session. But yeah, this guy had 3% equity on that hand and somehow won, but that's poker, right? So we got majorly pwned that session. So if you look at it, I mean, we were down, we ran about as bad as we could run there, right? And we were only down like 50 bucks. So it's a good damn thing we were just playing $5 hyper turbos today, right? or else it could have been really bad. I mean, if we ran that bad situationally or all-in wise and playing 100 and 200 and L, man, we'd be down like $400 today. So I feel like our timing's good. If we're going to run bad, let's run bad in these, right? So I'm going to go ahead and end the session. Thanks, everybody, for watching. Sorry I was sick today and couldn't do any better than I did or play anything differently or play different games, rather. But we'll certainly, unless I get worse, I think I'm peaking today again, so I'm hoping that I'll feel better tomorrow. But, you know, I'll at least come back and try to play some more of these or something tomorrow in case, you know, even if I feel bad. But thanks, everybody, for watching. We will see you tomorrow.